I was reading the Quran, actually I was listening to a lecture, and the brother must have said something about that the criminals will be in hell, yeah? And the word for hell that he used was sukkah, yeah? So the English translation for sukkah, when you read it in the Quran, it says hell. So I must have said, but then he started elaborating. So I went to a Quranic dictionary that I got, one of the sisters is holding it there. And I looked at this word, sukkah. SubhanAllah. Like, Allah says, nahar, kutamar, one of these kind of words for hellfire, but he chose sukkah. This means, yeah, like, you're trying to, like, say this is the edge, yeah? Like, picture Indiana Jones, yeah? And there's a wall behind you, and the wall is driving you off the edge. You're trying to stop from going off the edge, but the wall is driving you off the edge. And the place where it's driving you off this edge is just full of hardship, full of punishment, full of all the things that you just want to try to avoid. So when you hear that, yeah, and you compare it with the English translation that they will be driven into hell, it just doesn't match. When you see old man like this now, big beard, everything, shaking in his leather socks, crying, and he's standing right next to me thinking, why is he crying for? Why is he doing that for? He's shaking because Allah says sukkah, that they'll drive him into the hellfire where your skin won't remain the same, your skin will be blackened. Oh, let me just read the thing, man. Let me just read the thing. This is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. I'm not going to recite Arabic, I'll read it in English. It says, this is not but the word of a human being. I will drive him into sukkah. And what will make you know what sukkah is? It lets nothing remain and leaves nothing unburned. Altering, i.e. blackening the skins. Over it are 19 angels. Say no more, innit? Say no more. This is the English, but in the Arabic, the description of it is what's making the man shake. That's what's making him shake. Because there's nothing he can do. And I have to admit, every day we go on the road, we jeopardize our Jannah. Yeah? And we warrant this for ourselves. All the shortfalls that we ignore, all the shortfalls that we have in our actions, we're jeopardizing our Jannah. You don't know the description of Jannah. This is real talk. We're not going to be here for long. I just see a man who just got knocked over by a car on the crutches. He's lucky to still be alive. A man just got shot the other day through a window. He didn't even know that he was getting shot, and he's dead. Do you know what I'm saying? Real talk. Like, we are doing a lot of things that are jeopardizing our Jannah. To get jeopardizing our house, or jeopardizing our grades for education, to get a career, or doing something silly, we jeopardizing something that we will remain for eternity. When Allah rolls up, when Allah makes death into a land and slaughters that land, and then death no longer exists. So know that if your abode is in the hellfire, that's your place for eternity. And know that if your abode is in Jannah, that's your place for eternity, because death no longer exists. We can't turn around and open the door and step back into the dunya and say, khalas, I'm back. They don't work like that. There's a barzakh, like a barrier. Like, you can't go through this barrier. Even like you've got barriers that separate countries, or you've got the China wall, if you have the right tools, you can get through that wall. But this barzakh, there's no getting through this. That's it. So I thought that for me, this kind of shook my iman, squeezed my heart, and flipped it all around and everything. So I thought it might be a beneficial nasihah for you.